What do you do when you can't beat jet lag? You travel again! I'm going to Lisbon. KLM is sending me out to explore the westernmost European city. I've never been west of France, so I'm actually quite excited. I've heard many good things about Lisbon's sausage, Lisbon's beaches, and Lisbon's architecture. It's a very beautiful place, I've heard. I've never been. I'm very excited. Let's get on the flight. Also, before we head to the airport, I've got to let you know, I've got my Mavic back. It is now fixed. It is currently updating some firmware right now, and then we should have some sick shots on this trip, maybe of some secret castles. Let's go.
I just got recognized on the incredibly packed bus on the way to the station, except the girl didn't say anything to me. She just stood with her mouth agape, like, until I waved. So hi, if you're watching this. I finally got to Heathrow after a long and hot bus journey. If you didn't know, it's 31 degrees in London today. I'm boiling, all right? Boiling! Always get to the airport early, that's what I always say. It's not what I always say, but I am at the airport 2 hours on time, okay, before it leaves. I'd like some accolades in the comments, thank you very much. Got myself a $4 meal deal, gonna take a break, have a little relax, listen to Dear Evan Hansen.
Alright, super convenient, they've checked my bag for free all the way to Lisbon. Thank God, now I just have my hands.
Arrived in Amsterdam, KLM's hub. Time to get a drink. I'm so tired. I'm really jet lagged still, so I cannot wait to get a full night's sleep tonight. But right now, gonna find a place to relax. I don't have any time to relax yet. I've gotta get going.
Hey look, it's my watch. That's my watch. It's mine.
This way. Zoop, still this way. Oh, he's got somewhere to go. And he's got somewhere to go. Wow. Oh, hello.
A bit moist, but I've made it on to the second leg of my KLM trip to Lisbon. I honestly want to crack open a cold one with the boys. Give me a Heineken.
Flight has now landed. It's almost midnight. I think I'm just gonna get an Uber to the hostel to save some time. So what do you call it if the other big city in Portugal goes up in the air? Aeroporto. Well, I've still got my backpack, and as Alt J says, my left hand's free.
To Lisbon calling.
Well, good morning, guys, from Lisbon. I actually had quite a good sleep last night. I'm now out and about in the streets. I've never been in a city that actually looks like this, to be honest. What I know about Lisbon is that it's known for its very sprawling hills. Just lots of staircases I'll be walking up today. And at the top of that hill comes a choice of a ramp or more stairs. Oh, this is just day one. Definitely wish I had taken one of these guys now. These hills are brutal. After burning all of my monthly calories in 1 hour, I've now made it to Portugal's Bairro Alto, which if anything of my small knowledge of Spanish teaches me, which is in no way Portuguese, it's a tall community. It's actually upper district. I know they're different languages, okay. I've now made it to the Miradouro de São Pedro. If you're Portuguese, you're laughing at my pronunciation, I'm really sorry. Basically, it's a viewpoint. Here is the city of Lisbon. And if you look over there, there's a big old castle over there. That's where I'm hoping to go to soon today.
Just looks like a whole nother mountain I've got to climb.
So my lunch today was at a mall, and it was something called Aljeira Si Ovos. I'm assuming it's con ovos. I'm assuming that means with eggs, maybe, if it's similar to Spanish. I have no clue what it was. If you're from Portugal, please tell me what this was. I tried Googling it, still don't know what it is. All I know is that it's tasty. Also, Evan, what have you done? Have you changed? I wanted to wear something more Portuguese looking. So I wore stripes, a little sailor outfit. I don't know, basically, I didn't want to wear the same shirt over and over, so I popped into a Pull&Bear, got this for a steal, 10 euro. All right, let's go to a castle.
Why? Why?
Traveling alone isn't so bad. Sometimes you just gotta balance your camera on a rubbish bin. But you gotta get that shot. It's a really beautiful day out. Like, it's hot. It's not unbearably humid. The view is nice. The breeze is nice. Everything's nice. Just, oh man. You have to take a break when we get to the top of this hill.
I've now made it to the castle of São Jorge. There's giant cannons.
And sick views.
This castle has been around since the mid-11th century, and it's changed hands many times since then. At this point, it's just an archaeological site and a beautiful national monument to visit. If you have the chance, it's only €8.50 to come up here. It's a really nice view. It's really cool. I recommend.
Cuidado. Attention. There's falling people. Watch out.
So I just decided to throw the drone up, and it got attacked by a seagull who was viciously going after it. I had to land it immediately. I think this airspace is protected by seagulls. He's still looking for it.
This bird will not leave me alone. He's swooping at me still.
Well, I really wanted to have a cool shot of me standing at the castle and then the drone flying backwards so you can see the whole I couldn't do it. Literally within a minute of having the drone in the air, birds are back. They had gone, they came back. I'm not shooting here anymore. It was fun. Hope you enjoyed the shots that I got while I could.
These are probably the cutest side streets I've ever experienced. They look like a party is happening every night. Like every street has these really beautiful, colorful streamers all over the place. I guess we're now entering the area of Alfama. Alfamas live here.
The interesting thing about these streets in Lisbon is that I constantly feel like I'm walking onto like someone's property because they're so small, so narrow. They're just meant for pedestrians. So I'm like, oh, is that someone's house? No, it's just a restaurant. That was just a very small little restaurant. You can walk in there. There's another one.
So I'm here in Alfama with
Vera.
Vera, you don't live very far away. So she decided to join me because I tweeted I needed someone to join me for dinner. We're gonna get traditional food and fado. I don't really like fish that much, but when you're in Rome,
or Lisbon,
do as the Romans do, do as the Lisbons do. So can you explain to me what fado is?
It's our sort of traditional music.
Traditional music, and you said it's very sad and depressing.
Sort of, yes.
Good, I like depressing music. Guitar. It'll be like Dodi with a guitar.
Slightly different, I think.
Slightly different. Vera, did you know that in Portugal, the plants have pants? What?
Yeah.
Pant, those are called los plantalones, right? Los plantalones?
No, that's Spanish.
Stop, Beb. Stop. Beb, thanks for showing me around the restaurant. Have a nice day.
I'm now finally back at my hostel. I am so bushed. I did so much more today than I ever expected to do. I can't believe it was all one day. I can't believe that my drone got attacked by a bird. Crazy. Thank you very much for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. If you did, you know what to do. You can subscribe because I make these new videos every time I go traveling. A new one tomorrow. I'm going to a cool palace castle west of Lisbon. It's going to be sick. There'll be good drone shots. Hopefully, no birds. We'll see. Thanks. I'll stay tuned. I'll see you guys then. Goodbye.